Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. I'm Nila Rahmasina. Right now, I would like to explain you a collocation. For the first example is take a picture. Take a picture is include a strong collocation because we rarely say make a picture. Take a picture means make a photograph to create an image with a camera or to capture a picture. For example, I hope can take a picture with him. And next is strong coffee. Strong coffee is also included in strong collocation because we cannot say powerful coffee or hard coffee. Strong coffee means coffee that contains caffeine more than usual. For example, my father is always drink a strong coffee. And last is very excited. Very excited is include weak collocation because we can say extremely excited. Very excited means that someone feeling very happy or enthusiastic. For example, I'm very excited to join the class tomorrow.
Polysemy. Polysemy is a single word that has multiple related meanings. I will give you several examples of polysemy. The first word is key. Key can mean a small metal tool for unlocking doors or information used to decode encrypted data or a crucial factor in a situation. For example, in the sentence, please find the key for the front door. And the second example, this information is the key to decrypting the code. The second word is run. Run can mean to move swiftly on foot, or to operate a machine or system, or to organize and control an event or activity. For example, in the sentence, I enjoy running in the morning before work. And the second sentence is, can you run the washing machine for me? And the third word is hand. Hand, it can refer to the part of the human body, or it can also mean the power of control someone has over a situation or another person. For example, in the sentence, he reached out his hand to shake mine. And the second sentence is, she has a good hand in negotiations.
And the last, I will explain about homonyms. Homonyms are words that have same spelling and pronunciation but have different meaning. And homonyms are divided into two, namely homophones and homographs. Homophones are words that have same sound but have different meaning. For example, male and male, berry and berry, Nike and Nike, B and B, two, two or two. Each of these words have the same sound but have different meaning. And the next, homographs. Homographs are words that have the same spelling but different meaning. For example, bow and bow, wine and wine, life and live, lit and lit. Each of these words are spelled the same. So this is what we want to share about collocation, polysemy, and homonym. I hope you got the point, and goodbye.